Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Ajeev IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our series, in which what we do, we daily discuss some questions for the purpose of your prelims 2020. So the name that we have kept for this series is Let's Solve Some Questions for Prelims 2020. So as is clear from its name, so this series is not just about discussing questions but also about your participation in this discussion. So we expect you people to participate in the discussion and also participate by commenting in the comment box about about any additional information if you may have with you relating to questions discussed. So let's start our discussion. So today is video number 9 of this series. So we will be solving today questions from ancient India. So they might be from ancient India as well as art and culture. So first is, consider the following about Fahin's account of Gupta administration. First, he characterized the Gupta administration as despotic and malevolent. Second, there was no individual liberty in personal and cultural sphere as they were heavily regulated by the state. Third, he appreciated the efficiency of Gupta administration as he was able to travel without any fear throughout the Gangetic Valley. Fourth, there was widespread poverty and frequent famines. So we have to choose that which of these is correct, which of these is a part of Fahin's account of Gupta administration. So before discussing the answer, friends, you might be aware of the fact that Fahin visited India during the Gupta administration, and specifically during the reign of Chandragupta II. So he stayed in India for 9 years, out of which he spent 6 years in Gupta administration. So we find a detailed account of Fahin relating to Gupta administration. So first statement is wrong, because he characterized the Gupta administration as benevolent and welfare oriented. So first is incorrect, second is also incorrect. So he said according to him there was no interference in the personal spheres of the individual, and individual can go could go up anywhere in the empire. So that second statement is also wrong. Third statement is correct. He appreciated the efficiency of the Gupta administration due to its ability to ensure safe roads, because he said that that he was able to travel without fear throughout the Gangetic Valley. Regarding fourth question, friends, fourth question is also fourth statement is also incorrect, because he said in his account that the crimes were negligible in India during that time, because of the reason that poverty was very very less, and there was prosperity in general, so crimes were less. So the answer is C, that is third only is correct. So more detail in explanation you can check here. So I have given you the explanation, so there is no point of spending time on it, because all of these things have been explained by me to you. So now let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following with reference to visit of Yuan Shuang, that is Hun Sen, and his account of India. So before starting, you must be knowing that Hun Sen visited India during the Harshvardhan Empire. So first statement is, for the control of his extensive empire, Harsha relied upon his personal supervision rather than on services of a trained bureaucracy. Second, official records of public events were kept in every province by special officers. Fourth, ordeals by third is imprisonment was not practiced, that it was considered an inhuman punishment. Fourth, ordeals by water, fire and poison were instruments for the ascertainment of truth regarding an offense. So we have to choose that which of these is correct, which of these statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that the first statement is correct. We are told by Hun Sen that he traveled extensively and he was a man of great energy, and he believed in his personal supervision rather than on the services of trained bureaucracy. And also then second statement is also correct. We find mentioned that the official records were maintained by special officers who were to record both good events as well as evil events. And also then third is incorrect. Third is not correct, because imprisonment was practiced in during the Harsha's reign. So third is incorrect, but fourth is correct. The ordeals by water, fire and poison were instruments for the ascertainment of the truth regarding an offense. So the answer is D, that is 1, 2 and 4. So Often, in fact, not only we find mention about such type of punishment, that is for ascertainment of truth by giving water, fire or poison, but also we find approval of it by Hun Sang himself. So the answer is D. So here more details are given to you. So more or less statements are repeated. So there is no point of discussing or wasting time on it. You can pause the video if you want to read. I have already explained to you in detail. Now let's move to the next question. Next is Jatka tales have been painted in A. Varli temple, B. Ajanta caves, third Lipakshi temple, D. Rock shelters of Bhimbetka. So this question is quite easy, friends. Answer is B, that is Ajanta caves. So Jatka tales, Ajanta is one of the finest examples of some of the earliest Buddhist architecture, cave paintings and sculptures. So important paintings have been found in Ajanta caves, that and these paintings are the Jatka tales. So basically Jatka tales are the stories that that are related to the previous incarnations of the Buddha as Bodhisattva. So Bodhisattva is a saintly being who is destined to become Buddha. And when the Bodhisattva attains enlightenment, he becomes Buddha. So Jatka tales are basically the previous birth stories of the of Buddha when he was Bodhisattva. So this Ajanta paintings have also been declared World Heritage Site in 1983 by UNESCO, and also then the paintings and sculptures of Ajanta and Ellora are also considered the masterpieces of Buddhist religious art, and they have had a great influence in the development of art in India. And then in cave number 1 there is Mahajanak Jatka. So this Mahajanak Jatka, in which in this painting it is shown that the prince Mahajanak, that is the future Buddha, discusses with her mother the problems of the kingdom. So and his mother is shown in an extremely graceful pose and is surrounded by her maids. Now let's move to the next question. Next is the Bhumi Sparsh Mudra of Buddha symbolizes A. The earthly nature of all things in universe, B. The codependent rise and fall of all beings in existence, C. Buddha's victory over Mara, D. That the ultimate spiritual wisdom comes from the earth. So this is the mudra, friends. Total there are close to 8 mudras which are very important, which you must read. All the mudras you must be knowing. So here the answer is C, that is Buddha's victory over Mara. So in this, Gautama Buddha can be seen as holding his, keeping his left hand on his knee, right on his foot of right side, and then he touches the ground with the, you can see here, he touches the throne of the lotus with his finger. So this is also known as calling earth as witness mudra, or you are touching the earth mudra. So basically in it Gautam Buddha kind of, we can say, invokes earth as the witness of his victory over Mara, that is associated with death, evil and rebirth and desire in Buddhist cosmology. So this is also called touching the earth mudra or calling the earth to world witness. So right arm hands down over the right knee. So this gesture symbolizes Sakyamuni's victory over Mara. Mara in Buddhism is basically he was a demon that it is said that he tempted to tempted Prince Siddhartha by trying to seduce him with the vision of beautiful women who in various legends are described as Mara's daughters. So in Buddhist cosmology, Mara is also associated with death, rebirth and desire. So this is the question. Next is last question of the day. Sankhya philosophy of the Hindu, Sankhya school of Hindu philosophy can be described as one of the A. Rationalist school of Indian philosophy, B. Ascetic school of Indian philosophy, C. Devotionist school of Indian philosophy, D. Ritualistic school of Indian philosophy. So friends, the answer is A, rationalist school of Indian philosophy. So basically there are 6 schools of Indian Hindu philosophy, so you can read about them in your standard books, so also in NCERT books. So Sankhya philosophy regards the universe as consisting of two realities, that is Purusha and Prakriti. So Purusha is basically consciousness and Prakriti is matter. So when, according to Sankhya philosophy, when Purusha and Prakriti meets, when their fusion takes place, Jiva comes comes into being. So jiva is basically jiva is a living being is that state in which Purusha is bonded to Prakriti in some form. So you can simply say, if you have to understand in layman language, then Purusha is type of a kind of a soul and Prakriti is a kind of a body. So when they both they meet, this results in a living being, that is a jiva. So this fusion, according to Samkhya scholars, led to the emergence of the buddhi, that is intellect, and ahankara, so ego consciousness. So there are this school's beliefs that that Purusha Prakriti entities are infused with various permutations and combinations. So due to which we see this universe. And when, the Sankhya's philosophy believes that when there is a fusion between different elements of Purusha and Prakriti, this fusion takes place in multiple manners. But if any imbalance occurs in this fusion, and one or more constituents overwhelms the other, this results in bondage, particularly of the mind. But then if there is balance, then bondage is called liberation or kavalya or by the Samkhya schools. So this is about your fifth question. So friends, if you have scored 5 out of 5, the 3 to 4 or 5 marks, then it is good. And if you have scored 0, 1, 2, then it is also very much good, because at least you have solved some questions which you were not knowing earlier. So you now know their explanation and you can now relate them, or even if they are asked in UPSC prelims in one way or the other, you will be able to attempt these questions. So that is basically the approach. You must follow this approach. This series is not to test you. It is basically to get you through the to kind of make your introduction to various types of topics and how the UPSC frames questions. So obviously prelims is 6 months away, so if you solve daily 10 MCQs in this manner, you can improve a lot, because we are discussing daily 10 MCQs on this channel, that is 5 in the morning and 5 in the evening. So this can result in much improvement. So focus upon improvement rather than on scores. So this is all about today's video. And lastly friends, we also have different courses, for example history NCRT, geography NCRT's course, art and culture polity NCRT course, and then we have M. Lakshmikant book course, and then we have modern India course by Spectrum Publication. So all these courses you can join. Here we have some all history NCRT course, which the details of which are shown. That is, daily you are given a target to read, and in the evening you are given 10 MCQs from that target, or so all the NCRTs from 6th to 12th are covered. So in this way, 450 MCQs are covered in 45 days, and you get a single magazine of 450 NCRT based MCQs on the 45th day. So how it benefits you? Basically friends, you might be aware of the fact that NCRTs are the foundations. So every topper and other leading institutions give advice to aspirants to read NCRTs thoroughly, and then entire history is covered through MCQ mode, and this will ensure discipline in your studies, because most of the students are preparing for from home, and the problem they faced is the lack of discipline in their studies. And also then problem of revising NCRTs will also be solved, because all important topics will be covered in these MCQs. So you will not be just getting MCQs, but the in detail explanation will also be there. So you need not refer to different books again and again, and then you can revise your entire NCRTs through by going through these this single document that will be shared with you of 450 MCQs. And also when history NCRTs are widely believed as most comprehensive NCRTs, and also mere reading is not enough. You must know how the questions are framed by UPSC. So this idea only comes when you solve the MCQs, because reading is what is done by other persons also. For example, an individual who is studying in class 6, 10th, 8th, 12th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, so all they are doing reading. History is read by some persons as their hobby. So you must prepare for UPSC in a different manner, so that you can deal with the questions that are asked in UPSC CSE. So in that case, mere reading is not enough. You must know how the questions are framed by UPSC. So that idea comes only when you solve MCQs. And also when you prepare in disciplined manner, in a time bound manner, in the manner of daily targets, then this leads to much needed self confidence, because you complete your syllabus in a timely manner. So obviously now is the best time to start because prelims is just only 6 months away. So I don't know if you are waiting for anything, and if you are waiting, so what are you waiting for? We don't know. So now is the best time. So if you are willing to join, then do ensure that you check this link. So this link will also be provided in the description box. So in description box, the links of different courses that we have for the purpose of CSE preparation is given. So you can use those links to join our various courses, and also do ensure that you check the description box to check the link of our Telegram channel, public Telegram channel, where we have more than 15,000 subscribers that follow us, students that follow us, and these students who are there on Telegram with us, they get regular access to the various resources that we share for the CSE preparation. For example, the PDF of this discussion will also be uploaded in the Telegram channel of a Telegram channel, the link of which is in the description box. So if in case you are interested to get access to those public resources, you are more than welcome to join our Telegram channel, and you can join that by checking the description box. So this is all about today's video. Do ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and also ensure that you like this video and share it with your friends. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day.